When it comes to the future of energy supply, we often think about renewable sources such as wind energy or solar power. At the same time, however, the distribution of energy, the electricity grid, has to become much more flexible and resilient in order to feed the complex and dynamic needs of industries, energy communities, and end users. The EU-funded project ebalance-plus explores technical, economic, and social aspects of intelligent electricity grids. Various solutions have been tested at four demonstration sites located in Denmark, France, Italy, and Spain. At the University of Málaga in Spain, the eBalance Plus team has implemented and evaluated two energy grids that are linked to four buildings with different energy levels.
The demo site of Málaga is one of the most complex demo sites in the project because it's covering most of the technologies that we have developed. Actually, we have PV system, power inverters, EV chargers based on vehicle-to-grid protocol. We have batteries, we have smart devices, air conditioning control and flexibility, algorithms, very sophisticated algorithms to control. So we have plenty of technology playing at the same time.
One of the implemented grids addresses end users, such as owners of electric cars. Jacobo Peralta and his project partners have built a photovoltaic canopy and 10 vehicle-to-grid charging points that can be used as bi-directional docking stations. Ismael Navas already uses the vehicle-to-grid station in his daily life, generating valuable data for evaluation.
As a consumer, this will change the way of charging the car because the idea would be to charge every day the car and to put this energy in the grid whenever it's necessary. I think most of the people don't care about being part of the grid because they only care about having a plug at home to use the electricity. But for people having electric cars, it's a bit different because they are concerned about the use of the electricity because they have to care about how to charge the cars.
In fact, the car becomes part of the local grid, supplying power to the nearby university building and vice versa. People like Ismael enable the researchers to test hardware and software solutions that maximize the generation, storage, and use of local energy. One software solution is the Vehicle to Go app.
In this application, you can select the mode of the charging, bidirectional discharging or charging. You can select the time or the percentage or charging. And respect the global solution, we are using a GT inverter to export or import the energy from the grid to the DC link or in the inverse. You can use also the car battery and charge and recharge. We can monitor all the components under the ebalance-plus platform. You can control the flow of communication between them, and with this data, we can develop forecasting or prediction model to know in advance what will be the consumption of the building.
At the system's core is the DC-DC inverter. It enables the user to choose whether energy is taken from or fed into the grid. In order to respond to the complex technology used in this system, hardware distributors such as Ampere in Valencia have been brought on board. The Ampere team has extensive experience in constructing smart batteries, which can provide up to 120 kilowatt hours and buffer systems.
That's the SEMS buffer, like the one we have in the Málaga pilots. The buffer is mainly composed of three main components. One is the energy storage batteries, the racks. The other one is the bidirectional inverter. And the third one is our control box. And the control box, what we put inside is our EMS, our energy management system, along with some protections and some communication routers. And this provides control and communication for the full system to be integrated into the ebalance-plus platform through the API that communicates with our cloud. And also, this plays an important role regarding the installation of the systems because it makes life easier for installers because everything is concentrated here, all the connections, all the wiring is done at the factory. So the installer just needs to connect a few cables and that's all.
Within the eBalance Plus project, the implementation of smart grids has already been successful. To bring these technical solutions to market, though, new regulations in many EU countries still have to be implemented, and end users have to be actively included.
I know that in Spain it's very difficult to get an open vision with the solution because the infrastructure are very limited here. But I think that if we provide the technical solution and we get that the final user is an active participant, I think that we will get that the user are more comfortable to use this, are more responsible about the energy use of the energy.
I see that the future should be a future where the electricity and energy comes from renewable energies, and so we can use energy coming from the sun or from the wind and use this for our daily movement and not using other sources of energy that are more dangerous for our planet.
The objective of the European Commission is to achieve energy grids based on 100% renewable sources by 2050. Projects like ebalance-plus demonstrate that a flexible, resilient and balanced electricity grid that feeds the daily needs of our society is possible.